I'm the program coordinator at the St. Catharines Museum and Welland Canal Center here in St. Catharines, Ontario. And I've been working here for about 2 years now, and it's a great place for families and friends and seniors and tourist groups to come and visit. We have the Welland Canal Center, which has the viewing platform for Lock 3 of the Welland Canal system, as well as a beautiful history of the St. Catharines area with our St. Catharines Museum. And within the museum, we have the Welland Canals tour, which talks about the history of the four canals, as well as a great Black history tour, so you can learn a little bit about our culture as well in the Niagara region. Jane, so this is the first ship model to actually, it's a model of the first ship that made it through the canal once it was built. And they have a top hat ceremony every year in the spring to actually open the canal for the season. The St. Lawrence Seaway is here, as well as the captain of the first ship that goes through the canal. And then once we enter this area here, it's three towns and a township, so this is how the canal actually affected our community, the city of St. Catharines. Meriton, Grantham, Port Dalhousie. So we talk a little bit about Port Dalhousie and the picnic that's still, and the carousel that's still there today, and you can still ride it for 5 cents. So it's a great place for families to enjoy a picnic in the summer. And then here is our area, a little bit about Black history, about the churches and the schools. There's also the portrait of a city here. So here we talk about St. Catharines, Meriton, Grantham, and Port Dalhousie. We have a steam fire pumper. And here, during World War II, the fire pumper was actually slated for scrap metal for the war effort. But John Smith, a local heritage enthusiast, actually kept the pumper and made sure that it wasn't scrapped, so we have it here today. So in 1990, this fire pumper was moved to the new museum here at Lock 3. And then we talk a little bit about industry, so about agriculture and whatnot, and our manufacturers, early manufacturing in the city. This is a 1912 real motor car that was actually manufactured in St. Catharines, Ontario. Again, some local industry. And then we have our Freedom Seekers case that talks about the Freedom Seekers escaping to Canada for freedom. So talking about the Underground Railroad and the efforts of Harriet Tubman. To a little bit of our military tradition here in the local area. The War of 1812 will be celebrated very shortly in 2012. HMCS St. Catharines, the Battle of the Atlantic,
the naming of Canada's naval ships. And then here we talk a little bit about World War I and World War II, a little bit of black history here as well, and the War of 1812. And the last area of the museum is more about sports in St. Catharines. So we have some famous athletes as well here in our local region. Derby, curling, hockey, Jerry Cheever's goalie mask. And Brian Bellows' niece is actually working for us this summer. And then finally we bring in special exhibits three times a year. So right now we have Sitting Pretty, the History of the Toilet from the Guelph Museum. So that's our latest exhibit that we have on loan. So this will be here till the end of August. And we also build temporary exhibits in this area here. And right now we have an exhibit all about wedding dresses, the history of wedding dresses. So bridal bliss is just in the corner, just around through the curtains here. So this is the latest exhibit that we just opened on June 18th. So all about wedding traditions. We've got dresses here from our collection as well as dresses on loan. Here in the corner is actually three generations of dresses. So there's the grandmother, the mother, and the three daughters. For stopping by today, and I encourage families in the Niagara region to come on out, learn a little bit about the history of St. Catharines and the Welland Canals, and have the opportunity to see a huge laker in the Welland Canal system at Loch 3. Thank you.